Hey, this is Ben. I want to demonstrate some of the new remote control features we've added for MixBus version 3.1. Today I'm going to be talking about the Mackie Control Surface Protocol, which allows a lot of motorized fader devices to be connected to MixBus. And we have all kinds of cool features built in that operate the MixBus controls. So let's jump right into it. Alright, so the first step is I'm going to demonstrate how to get set up with the Mackie Control Protocol. So we open our MixBus Preferences window. And I'll switch to the Control Surfaces tab, and you see my four control protocols. I'm going to choose the Mackie row and click the Enabled checkbox, and then double-click on it to open the configuration. Now, the device type is where I choose which device I'm using. In my case, I'm using a Behringer X-Touch. There are lots of other choices you can get. You can get a Mackie version or one from Avid and all kinds of controllers that have motorized faders and speak this Mackie protocol, but we're using the Behringer X-Touch, and the items on this list, they tell MixBus how many faders and whether there's a jog wheel and whether there's a master section. It tells us some details about the layout of the control surface so that we can map it sensibly. So after we've chosen our device, we have to choose where the USB connection is that feeds this, where the MIDI connection is that feeds into MixBus. So this particular device has two MIDI ports on it, X-Touch internal, X-Touch external. Internal is all the knobs and switches that you see, whereas external refers to the two MIDI ports that are on the back. So we need to use X-Touch internal for both input and output. You hear the faders jumping into position. So that's how we get our basic setup with the Mackie. And we'll continue on to look at the transport section. All right, so let's quickly investigate some of the transport functions. I'm going to start from the bottom and work my way up. So at the very bottom, we have a directional pad that lets us walk up and down through the tracks on our session. And it allows us to step left and right in the timeline. And then there's a jog wheel, which allows us to scroll through the session with the playback head. And we have channel buttons that choose our channels and faders. We'll talk more about those later. Then we get into the basic five-key transport section. We've got a play button, stop, rewind, and fast forward. You can create markers by clicking the marker button, and if I want to advance through the markers, I can hold marker and press rewind or fast forward to move through the markers. There's also a nudge button. If I hold nudge and press forward and back, then it will move the playhead forward or back by the nudge amount, which is set in a MixBus preference. Then we have the cycle button, which starts looped playback. We have two buttons labeled drop and replace. Now, we don't have the equivalent of drop and replace in MixBus, so we've created something new here. This is a really cool feature that allows me to start and end a range selection from the jog wheel. So drop is your mark in and replace is mark out, if you're familiar with hardware audio and video editors. So I've marked in and marked out, and I've selected a time range that I can then edit in some way. Or I can use it from this control surface to trigger a couple of different events. If I hold shift and click marker, then it sets my session start and end to match that range that I set. Or if I hold shift and click cycle, then it sets my loop range to match the range that I selected. And if I hold shift and click, then it sets the punch in range. Now, speaking of punch in, I can also enable punch in and punch out from these buttons. So if I hold shift and press drop, I've now enabled the punch in time. And if I hold shift and press replace, then I've enabled the punch out time. So now if I roll through that period of time, you can see these lights are blinking. That indicates that it's going to automatically arm the transport and punch me in and punch me out as I go through that range of time. So the next button is click. I can turn the metronome for the session on and off. And finally, there's a solo clear button that clears all the solos in the session. That's basically the transport features. Next up are the modifiers and automation. Let's quickly talk about the modifiers, the automation section, and these utility buttons. The modifiers are used, obviously, to modify the effect of these other buttons. Currently, we have several features mapped to use shift plus the button to do default actions, but the other three modifiers are left available so that you can assign actions, so that control cycle can do something special that you, the user, wants to set it up to do. So I'll return to that in a few moments. Let's look at the automation section. The automation section is set up to control the automation for a fader. So if I select a single channel, I've got to click on a fader on the control surface to select that channel. And then I can assign touch automation, read automation, or write automation to that particular fader. The utility section has a save button, which saves your session. It has an undo button, which undoes your last edit move. And if I hold shift and click undo, then that's a redo. It also has a cancel button, which cancels all of your current selection. So it deselects all the tracks, regions, anything you have selected. Plugins will be deselected when you press cancel. And then enter selects all tracks, and that's useful for editing sometimes. Now above that, we have 8 function keys. These don't do anything by default. They are left alone so that you, the user, can assign what you want to do with these. So I mentioned earlier that I had made a range selection, and I might want to delete the time there, or I might want to separate out that clip of audio into a separate clip. So let me quickly show you how to go in. I'd like to show you how to go into the editor. So I'm opening my Mackie configuration page. I'm going to click Function Keys on the Function Keys tab, and then choose the user layout. And you see on the left side all of the buttons that are available for me to assign. Now most of them are already assigned. Most of the buttons are already assigned to do a specific task, okay? But the F keys, I can click this dot and choose any action that's available in the MixBus menu. For example, I like to use F8 because it's easy to access from the side of the machine here. I like to use separate. So now when I click F8 on my control surface here, that's going to separate the piece of audio that I picked out with my jog wheel. And you also have, if you look at this, lots and lots of options. All of the F keys, all 8 of the F keys, can be modified with the shift, control, option, command, or shift plus control. So you have a wealth of different functions you can access from within this menu. That pretty much summarizes all the things you can do with the Mackie control protocol, the master section, the transport stuff, and all the editing. But the next video, we're going to get into all the details of getting into the MixBus mixer features, the EQ, compressor, MixBus sends, and all those kind of things.